Tolik, I gotta ask you a question. Nate Diaz says everybody's on steroids. Do you believe that?
Partially.
Why?
Partially why? If you ask me this question like a year and a half ago, I said no, I didn't believe. When my son fought some MMA fighter and he lost, and the guy got cut on steroids. And
the guy in the past had steroid problems.
Yeah. He got history on steroids. Most of the MMA fighters used steroids.
Why do you say that? How can you say that?
That's what people said. I didn't have any proof, but most of the high professional, because if you go on high performance level of boxing or any kind of sport, football, boxing, MMA, so you need, the body needs support, because people doesn't want to train consistently, and people don't train consistently, they do breaks like 3 months, 4 months, 1 year, back to gym. You can't normal back to gym. So take some help, farm help them. But again, I'm personally me against, I don't know nothing about steroids. I'm not used steroids, I've never used, I'm never gonna use. But I know people using, I know people destroyed it. Not boxers, coaches. The coaches just bring him. I don't want to tell names. I know 100% who does. So the coaches just bring.
It's bad for your liver, kidneys,
testicles,
everything.
Steroids is thing. So if you take steroids, all your body inside to start grow. Your heart, you can get
forehead,
heart attack.
Forehead, eyebrows.
You can get heart attack during the sleep.
The bicep tears a lot. I've
seen everything. Heart, kidney, liver, everything start growing.
So let me ask you this. VADA, who does the drug testing, is non-profit, Tolik. To me, it's a business, like everything in boxing is a business.
Of course it's business.
They charge $25,000 for tests.
Of course it's business.
Why don't they charge $5 and test everybody?
Yeah, this is another thing. This is like the monopoly of VADA, and I think it's the biggest problem
I'm not
sport,
a fan.
Biggest yeah. problem is part of sport of boxing. The biggest problem. It's supposed to be different companies to do this or volunteer or do this for minimum charge.
Correct. Do it for free. You're not
like profit. Volunteer. Yeah. Save a lot of lives.
Yeah.
And save a lot. This is also supposed to be maybe for under government support and maybe under California Athletic Commission support. It's supposed to be, because the one that charge a lot of money. Okay. I wanted, for example, my son, just example,
yes.
fighting main event with some guy. I told him, no problem, we're gonna get tight fight. VADA, I want VADA test. VADA said, no problem, $25,000.
That's crazy. Your son not even making $25,000.
And the fight gonna be apart, because on the side, he doesn't want to pay $25,000.
But
I'm ready to
Margaret pay. Goodman, their lady, is being inducted into the Hall of Fame. There's only two categories, fighters and non-fighters. They could put in Roger Mayweather. They could put in Robert Garcia, Eddie Reynoso, Derek James, a lot of coaches. Why are they putting this lady in? She shouldn't be going into the Hall of Fame.
Again,
it's a business. I know.
It's a business, and nobody knows, not me, not you. Probably this lady, she knows somebody, or she have relative somebody.
Or we're going to see a big sign, congratulations.
Yeah, look what happened with Newsom here in California. Why you go far away, but Newsom in California, everybody knows because of Pelosi, Newsom became governor. Unbelievable. Everybody knows, everybody shut their mouths, nobody talks. Everybody
happens. I also don't like that Victor Conti is a big fan of VADA.
If this happened on level of government, why is not gonna happen in VADA?
In
why
boxing,
is gonna
yeah.
happen in boxing or MMA?
But why is she in the Hall of Fame? Yeah.
It's gonna happen any sport. This is called corruption.
Yeah, but like I said, I agree with you. They should test everybody for free.
Yeah.
They're non-profit.
No, I would say mandatory.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would say mandatory. It doesn't matter. You good fighter, you bad fighter, main event.
But don't charge people $25,000.
Charge $25.
Yeah.
Open
but test everybody.
You open your organization. Come to the gym, morning, daytime, three times. Come to the gym, test the guy. You go fight, test the guy. Yeah.
But everything's a business, Tolik. I don't know what they're worth, but I wouldn't be surprised if they make a profit of $1 million a year. I don't know. It's a non-profit. They don't pay tax. So who knows how much money they make?
The non-profit make more money than people who make profit. Just to let you know. Who does non-profit?
What do you think they're paying Goodman a month? Do you think she gets paid 20,000, 30,000?
I never did non-profit, but I know who does non-profit organization.
They make good money.
On the for everybody drive Toyota Corolla, you see the fucking living mansion in Beverly Hills. So it's like kind of, you know, you never know. I don't want to be.
Listen, one time I did a true story. I'm going to tell you something.
It's all bullshit.
I did a story about an orphanage to help them with the Clippers make a basketball game, and I helped. And I did everything for free to volunteer my time. And the guy from the orphanage was staying at the Peninsula Hotel, $1,600 a night. You're collecting money for kids with no parents.
You're talking about a basketball game. Talk about USA Boxing. Why you don't talk about USA Boxing?
Because I don't know them.
It's a non-profit organization. Yeah.
They make a lot of money.
This, what is the John Brown guy?
I don't know.
I know exactly what happened. So I don't want to be I know exactly what happened.
Everything's a business. That's
everything
all I'm going to say.
Business, but officially it's non-profit. But yeah. It's 100% business.
Yeah.
Million percent business.
I agree.
Profit business.
So I don't want to see this lady in the Hall of Fame, and I don't want to see Vada charging people $25,000.
The problem in America, people scare from each other. The people scare, I don't want to talk, he's going to sue me. I don't want to lose money. They're all bullshit. The people scared. It's supposed to be here. Okay, if you write, go. Go, just go. Don't stop. All this steroid shit, that's just what they're going to do. They're going to just break the sport down. That's what they're going to do. Look what happened now with all these fighters. All these fighters who took steroid. You know what steroid does. So if you take steroids, I hit you, you don't feel. You're losing your feeling. So you understand, you miss punch and you actually don't feel anything. You're gonna feel this punch in maybe in 1 week, in 2 weeks. But that time, you don't feel anything. Punches to the head, punches to the body, but all
stamina,
all crowd happy. Oh, one of the guys bleeding. Oh, one of the guys throw up. Oh, he defeat prospect of the top end.
Yeah.
People so stupid. That motherfucker took steroids and nobody knows, and we call and we find out and we have proof, we show to top rank proof the guy motherfucker on steroids. And he says, okay, I'm sorry, we didn't know that. That's it, the whole business about it.
Yeah, there you have it. They need to do a better job testing, maybe WADA, maybe USADA, maybe a new organization. Totally, maybe I'll start a new organization to test people for cheap. Not to make money, just to help the sport. FaceNewsReporting.com and Sick Back Reporting.